Getting the Lagunitas brown sugar. Get some brown sugar, baby. Put it on your flapjacks. Happy New Year, everybody. Welcome to another year, a whole nother year of Who's Drinking What. Thank you for joining us. I'm Peter Hines alongside Brooke Scott.
Welcome back and Happy New Year, everyone.
We're being recorded here at the wonderful Tap Beer Bar in the downtown Bloomington, a wonderful craft brewery bar. If you're a first-time listener coming to the show, this is a podcast with just a couple of guys drinking, hanging out with craft beers, just loving them.
Talking about whatever.
Yeah. And hopefully you get interested in some, you hear something you've had and just remember it fondly. And for me, one thing this show's already opened up, I've kind of gone into it. I'm a big craft beer lover, but I wasn't a huge fan of like stouts and porters. I don't really like the real bitter stuff. But I just found out I was drinking the wrong kinds. I like some of them. I was just excluding it, and now I wonder how many good ones I've missed. I don't know. Any things like that? Some New Year's beersolutions for you, Brooks. I'm going to try new styles or...
I don't know. I like to keep my options open all the time, so I don't know how much more I can do, but I'll drink about whatever.
Well, maybe just drink more.
I guess.
Can't really do that.
I'll try my best.
Without losing his career.
Yeah.
Well, we have already ordered our first beers. They're sitting in front of us, and I forgot to do it last week, but in honor of Christmas, we have chosen each other's beers.
Yes. The kind spirit of giving.
Yeah. Because I trust you enough to give me something I think will be tasty, and I've hopefully given you something you'll enjoy. So, Brooks, Happy New Year.
Cheers.
Mine's powerful.
Woo.
Not necessarily in an alcoholic sense, I should say.
That's pretty good.
Mine is an American IPA, and I get all of the hops up front. Here, I'll actually read you my description. I should have had it prepared better. Brooks, you ordered me the Boulder Slope Style from Boulder, Colorado.
Yeah.
It says that it's red in color, and it is a very red beer. With a perfect blend of five quality malts and a blast of horizon hops. And actually, I can't say if I've had horizon hops before because I usually don't think of them. I mean, Cascade I'm fairly familiar with, but this has a different bite to it. So I'm going to say this might be my first experience, at least notable experience with horizon hops.
There you go.
I enjoy it. It's got a lot of bite up front, but it smooths out very, very clean at the end. No lingering aftertaste, really. It's good.
That's good. All right. On to me. Peter so graciously ordered me the Lagunitas Brown Sugar. S-H-U-G-G-A, for those of you with spelling issues. It is a barley wine from California. It's 10% alcohol. I don't really need to read you the description. The end of it says it's rich, roasty, and mysteriously drinkable. All you need to know is it's a barley wine. It's freaking punchy in the face, strong. But it is very drinkable. I like it. It's great.
It's supposed to, yeah, literally have a lot of brown sugar to kind of smooth out the end of it.
I agree. Yeah, it's definitely a barley wine, though. That's one thing that I don't ever really drink a lot of is barley wines. That's my New Year's resolution. Drink some more barley wines.
See, I'm opening your horizons. Opening them up.
This one's great, though.
Plus, with that 10% alcohol content, you're going to be wide open like a book soon.
You only need a couple.
Spilling all the secrets. Probably not professional to talk into my beer. man, that is very crisp. I like it. All right, well, coming up on the show, we do have a This Day in Beer History for you later, so stick around for that. And we're going to be trying a new game after the first break. But, Brooks, last time on the show, when we were talking with our guests, who I want to thank again, Dan McGowan, Ben Erickson, and Karen coming down,
mm-hmm.
came up that I knew you were a Game of Thrones fan, but also a closet Potter nerd.
Oh, yes. Yes, I
am. I don't even know what the Nimbus was. Like, I didn't really pick up on it till I was editing the show later that...
Yeah? I can't remember what the situation was last week.
Ben, because one of the beers on the Guessa game was the Golden Nimbus.
Right.
And Ben was thinking I maybe pulled it from Harry Potter, which, I mean, I enjoyed the movies. I never read mm-hmm. the books, but you knew right away that it was a broomstick.
Oh, God, that's right. Okay.
Did you read the
books?
You
know what? Yeah, when I was a kid, I did read the books, and now my wife and I are fans of the movies.
Okay.
You know, we watch them when they're on, but I did read the books as a kid. It's great. I don't have much else to say about it.
Oh, that's fine. That's fine. Are you looking forward to Game of Thrones?
I am. That's something I got into kind of late, and I kind of binge-watched.
Mm-hmm.
Like the entire series up to this point, which I don't know when I did that, maybe 6 months ago, a year ago.
Yeah.
About, but God, that's such a good show, isn't it?
I don't think I really got into it until, what are they, through season four right now? Season
four
five
or
is
five.
The next one.
Is five coming up or is six coming up? Maybe it's five. Maybe you're right. I don't know.
Yeah. I think.
I watched them all in a huge line, so I'm not really sure.
I got in on it before 3 and 4.
Okay.
So, excellent show. I mean, it's one of those shows, if you're not a fan, we can't really discuss it because almost any discussion that will come up about the show, if you're not totally current, there's so much that goes on.
Mm-hmm. Every episode, something major happens.
Yeah, so we're not a spoiler cast or anything. But I thought that was interesting.
Mm-hmm.
And totally swinging topics again. Speaking of interesting, you happen to watch any football last night, some New Year's football?
I watched a lot of football yesterday, pretty much all day.
I did too.
There were some great games yesterday, yes. I'll tell you that much.
I love New Year's Day bowl games.
The Big Ten really showed out yesterday and put a thumping on some people, and I couldn't be more happy about it.
Yeah, because in past years, I mean, they're lucky if they won two of their bowl games.
I know it.
Three on New Year's.
The high and mighty SEC West took quite a thumping yesterday
yeah.
on New Year's Day.
And I think it kind of proves that the playoff system works.
It does, yeah.
I'll give Ohio's. I'm a Michigan fan, so and I don't really like Alabama, you know. It's kind of getting tired of seeing them constantly being good. But that – excuse me. Trying to get over a cold. Might cough through the episode, so I do apologize to anyone listening. But I was just rooting for a seesaw battle, you know, just a good game.
Yeah, yeah.
And, my God, they gave it to us.
They sure did. Gosh, I don't know. It was a good day of football. Good day of football. I was reading something after the games were over last night that said if this year they would have done what they've done in the past, like the BCS, computer picks, the whatever, it would have been Florida State and Alabama in the national championship game.
Oh, that would have been not the best matchup.
Now they're both knocked out.
Yeah.
That Oregon-Ohio State game should be exciting. A lot of offense.
The funniest thing I actually saw – it was, I think, early in the Oregon-Florida State game. Did you see when Jameis basically fell over himself and fumbled?
Yes.
And the ref, like, sympathy?
Everyone fell. Have you seen the vines, like, on Twitter and stuff that they've been putting up?
The Lance Stevenson one?
Yeah, him blowing him over. And there's one with Randy Orton coming out and RKOing him.
No, yeah. That's awesome.
It's pretty hilarious.
Yeah, that was, I mean... That was just a boneheaded play on Jameis's part. And then mm-hmm. to watch the rep. And the second time I saw it, I didn't pick it up. Like, the clicker flew out of his hands, too. I mean, it was like a carbon copy. Jameson falls and loses the ball. The ref falls and loses his clicker.
I'm not really sure what the ref was trying to do there. I don't know if he's trying to.
Oh, God. And did you see how buff he was?
Yeah, I did.
God, Ed Hockulete is like a disease and... refereeing. They're all turning into 60-year-old meatheads. I don't think that's what the world really needs.
Maybe. I don't know.
I've got my freaking ringer on. Sorry for anyone who might have heard that.
Well, that's all right.
We're an amateur show.
No calls during the podcast.
I am really enjoying sipping on this, by the way. Thanks again.
Hey, I'll pick your beer anytime.
Boulder Slope style.
I don't know if I've had any other Boulder beers.
We might have to do that. Maybe do twists on it, too. Try to pick something that you think the other person might not like and see how well that goes, because you never know.
Could be fun.
So, we'll probably end up both picking pumpkin ales.
Oh, God.
Not our favorites.
Fruit lambic.
You know what? I will say that one episode after Thanksgiving when you had to miss, Jessica was on. She got one of the fruit lambics, I believe, and it was really good.
Really?
I mean, because we're only having two a show. I guess I'm a little more selective with what I'm picking, and I probably should be picking a lot more random stuff on the menu, but that was a very drinkable beer, and it was not as overly fruity as I really thought. Huh. Like, it was a legit beer.
Which one? This Lindeman's is always on tap here, I feel like.
It
it's
is.
One fruit lambic that's always here. It's from Belgium.
I feel like it wasn't that one.
Yeah.
I doubt it's on the menu.
I don't know anything about those kind of beers, to be honest.
Yeah. Not my forte of knowledge either.
No.
Right. Well, I think we're about time for our first break.
Yeah.
I do want to say for anyone listening, if you guys listen through iTunes. Please give us a subscribe. This is a weekly show. If you like it, it'll auto update. You don't even have to listen to it right away. And then we're also on Podomatic, which is a site we're actually hosted on.
It's a great site.
Yeah,
I've never heard of it until we started doing this show, and I've kind of been exploring it. It's pretty cool.
And there's a lot of great stuff on there. But yeah, I think they give you good tools to really kind of customize it, and it's kind of like our homepage now. So.
Mm-hmm.
And we're also on the YouTubes, this new fangled video player. I don't know why I've started just trying to ruin my internet.
That's all right.
But yeah, if you like us, give us a subscribe. We're coming live from the tap every week.
Every Friday at 3:00.
All right.
You won't hear it then.
Well, we're gonna put on some of the great music that Tim O'Malley's provided for us, go to break, and when we come back, we've got a new game we're gonna try that we are calling Drink It, Buy It, or Dump It. Should be fun.
Shadows fall to my window.
All right, we're all set for a new game. And, in fact, during the break, we've changed it a little bit.
We had a change of heart.
Thought better of it.
Mm-hmm.
So it's going to be buy it, guzzle it, dump it.
Okay,
A little take on the fuck it, marry it, kill it game.
Sure,
that you'll hear
similar
played.
Parameters.
Yeah, so... Yeah, guzzle it, I think, gives you the idea that you just got to have it now. You know, the just more primal taste. And then the buy it is like, you know what? This is a long term. I can keep bringing it back home. It's nice, steady.
Keep this one around a while.
Totally. And then dump it is,
yeah,
don't need this one around. And actually, it's possible none of them will be, ugh. Maybe.
True, maybe.
Or you might have two that you gotta keep one of them around. And how we're doing this is we're keeping it in a single style of beer. And maybe we can change up things later, but for now, it's in a single style. Brooks has chosen the Scottish style. I have chosen stout. And Brooks, I'll let you go first.
All right.
If you want to start tasting. I'll let him taste all three and kind of make his decision that way.
All right, then. Are you going to, like, read the description as I go, or do you want me to say what I got? Or
yeah, How about I do that? That way you can just concentrate on what's going on in your mouth. That didn't come off the best.
All right. Well, here we go.
So the first one that he is trying is the Brooklyn Winter. And it says that it's a richly malted, with Scottish malted Maris Otter, crystal, aromatic, and roasted malts. It's got oats hopped with Willamette and satisfyingly malty and rich.
Willamette, huh?
Yeah, I think those are all different types of hops. Or not hops, malts, excuse me.
I had no idea what that was.
It was not my best reading of a description. But, so we finished that one off.
Okay.
Now, and I should say, too, while he's getting into it, I kind of brought it up last show, but in the Scottish style, there's actually a few different variants. So these are all listed as Scottish ales. Two of them are the lighter, and then the Oskar Blues, which is he's about to tackle here,
a little
is
darker.
The heavier. Yeah, it's got more of a color of like a stout.
All
but
right.
They are all still Scottish beers. They all stay within the malty caramel side of things. And yeah, his Oskar Blues Old Chub there, and it's an on-nitro. Features a dense head, creamy mouthful and flavors of caramel, chocolate, and lightly roasted malt. Complex and rich, it finishes with a crisp with a whisper of smokiness. So he's kind of taking that one down. I have a feel. I'm just going to guess that might be your guzzle at one of the three.
Yeah.
Because how much you enjoy your nitros. Just my personal.
I do like some nitros.
See how well I know you.
On to the final one, I guess, here.
And that one is the Terra Nina Sheepshagger.
Sheepshagger, alrighty.
Which I had the pleasure of last week. And the description for that one, while he's taking it down, is that it's a rich, malty, and full-bodied. It's brewed with specialty roasted malts for a complex blend of caramel and toffee flavors and a subtle peaty character.
I think I've reached my decision.
Alright.
Is that how we're going to do it? Just
yeah. Which one do you want to guzzle, Brooks?
For guzzle it, I'm going to go with the Old Chub on nitro. Definitely.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Yeah.
Best one then.
Alright. For buy it, I'm going to go with the Sheepshagger, the Tyrannina? Is that
Tyrannina,
how you say it? Tyrannina?
Out of Wisconsin.
And dump it. I'm going to go with the Boulder Winter. Is that what it was? Boulder Winter?
Yeah, the Boulder Winter. Now, were any of them close? Was it, like, obvious?
I think it's pretty obvious. I didn't really like the Boulder that much. But Scotch ales aren't something I'm that familiar with. I just recently kind of started drinking them. I know they're your favorite kind of beer.
It really might be.
But it's something I haven't really got into, but the Sheepshagger, I think by far was my favorite there. It's pretty tasty. I know you had that last week. Do you like it?
Yeah, I really enjoyed it. So you think that's your favorite? That's why you want to buy it?
So I want to buy it, have it around for
keep
a long time.
Keep bringing it back?
Yep.
Time after time. All right.
Yeah, that the Old Chub on nitro, guzzle it, definitely. It's that's smooth.
Yeah.
Smooth.
I think the nitro makes it a nice guzzle, too, because, you know, it's not going to be the same if you buy it and bring it home.
Right.
All right. I like that. Smart picks. So I got the stouts. And what's great about the tap is that they always have about 40 beers on tap. But then when something's empty, they just turn it over with a completely different kind.
Mm-hmm.
Putting these games together, you can access their menu online, but you never know when something's going to get
tapped
out.
Right, it changes out daily.
So, I got two of them from the same brewery, which is Dark Horse, which I enjoy. But when I was putting it together, they had a lot more stouts on tap, and then they must have had like a stout convention because there was like four of them that are gone.
Blown out.
I'm gonna take my first one and see how it goes.
All right, he's off with his first one. His first one is Brooklyn Black Chocolate. It is a Russian Imperial Stout. Brooklyn is in New York. For those of you that did not know that. The description is, this highly sought-after brew is a classic Russian Imperial Stout modeled on the beers made by British brewers for the Tsar's court in the 19th century.
So, okay. So it's British-made for Russian Tsars.
Correct.
I always wondered where it came from.
Correct.
Why it was called a Russian Stout.
All right, you on to the second one now?
I am. I'm going to leave a little taste of all of them, then maybe go back.
Okay. Number two here is Dark Horse One Oatmeal. It is a sweet stout. Breweries in Michigan. It says this beer is full-bodied with hints of chocolate, roasted barley, coffee flavors, and a nice creamy head.
It is quite a bit sweeter.
Yeah.
Although the Russian stout, I will say, still had a nice sweetness to it.
Really?
But it was much more subtle.
Okay.
It really wasn't like bite your head off bitter like some Imperial stouts I think can get.
And his third and final one is, once again, another Dark Horse beer. It is Dark Horse 2 Cream. It says, this beer is made with milk sugar, lactose, which gives this beer a nice creamy mouthfeel, which mingles with hints of chocolate and roasty flavors. By the look on his face...
That's my dump it.
Not good. Folks, not good.
That's my dump it.
We found his dump it.
Sorry, 2 Cream.
Thoughts?
Yeah. I'm sure it's fine for a stout. It was a bit bitter.
Yeah.
For me. Or a little more of the coffee presence.
Okay.
I mean, it still had a sweetness to it. I don't want to take that away from it. The description's not wrong. It just...
Not for me.
No.
Fair enough. All right, so he's got his dump it, folks. Let's see what he decides between guzzle it and buy it.
This is not going to be an easy decision, actually.
Uh-oh.
It's interesting, the Brooklyn Black Chocolate's listed as a 10% alcohol.
Really? Do you get that at all, or...?
Yeah.
Yeah?
But it's subtle in there. You know, it's not like it's a high alcohol burn. Like, I know it's there.
Yeah. Just letting you know I'm here.
It's crafted well. You know what? I'm going to go guzzle the Brooklyn Black Chocolate.
Ooh.
And I'm going to buy the one oatmeal.
Yeah? You like the one oatmeal?
I do. Now, I'm actually going guzzle it because this is maybe the best.
The black chocolate?
I think the black chocolate's my favorite. And so I just want to get as much of it as I can.
Right now.
Right now. Get into it. I got to remember this is not a video cast. I don't think anybody knew what I did there. And it's not worth relaying. But this oatmeal, I think, would be good just from time to time to, like, pick a bottle and have one.
Fair enough.
So, yeah, I'll buy that.
And there you have it.
That's been Guzzle It, Buy It, Dump It. So, if anybody wants to leave comments, say if you like the game or not, if we should continue it, or if we should dump it. Leave, I think Podomatic, you can leave comments. YouTube, you can. We're also on, have a Gmail. It's whosdrinkingwhat@gmail. So go ahead and email us. And I would like to start doing viewer questions. So if anybody wants to email us or ask a question on the comment board, we'll definitely try to cover it as best we can.
Definitely.
With our small yet extensive personal style of beer knowledge.
There you go.
Yeah. We think we know a lot, but I don't know. Some questions might prove how little we'll know.
I could make or break us there. I don't know.
What do you think, Brooks? Did you like it?
I liked it.
It's interesting. You get to try a lot of very similar, but be real critical. It's almost like the Miss America of beer.
Oh, well.
This might be the closest I ever get to a beer judging contest. All right. We're going to take another break. We'll be back. Stay tuned because we do have a This Day in Beer History.
Everyone's favorite part of the show.
Hell yeah, it is.
Especially mine.
And we'll have our second beers and a brewery spotlight for you guys.
I like girls in cut-off blue jeans. Is that really oh so bad? Sometimes I think I miss my calling. Should have been Sir Galahad. Memories, they come to me. I find I see places I'd like to be. My mind, it runs in circles for what seems forever.
Okay. Next round of beers are here, and I'm so excited. Brooks, when I was doing the prep for the show, and I saw the menu, and I saw the beer I got on there, I was just so excited.
He was pretty happy.
I try not to pre-select my beers.
He planned it out.
This one I was getting. And I wanted it second because it'll be the just best, like, finishing beer.
Mm-hmm.
the Oskar Blues Old Chub. And you know what? I'll read the description after we have it. But God, it looks so good.
It looks great. And it's, right. It's on nitro, mind you.
Yes. And I've never had it on nitro before, which added to my excitement of having it. So, Brooks.
Yep.
Let's
cheers.
Drink up.
Whew.
Have you ever heard of people talking about making beer sundaes?
No.
Like if you, this would be the beer that you could throw a scoop of ice cream in, and it would be delicious.
Tasty.
It's just so smooth and sweet and malty.
Tell you what, this one might not be a bad one for that either, to be honest.
That's true. You got the Dark Horse.
I did. I got the Dark Horse One Oatmeal.
Which I just had in the last game.
Yeah, he just tried it. It's good. I wonder if they have any ice cream here.
Yeah, I think you're right.
We could have a nice little dessert. Well, even though you already read the description, I'll read it again. It said, this beer is full body with hints of chocolate, roasted barley, coffee flavors, and a nice creamy head. It's a sweet stout, and it is indeed that. It's really sweet on the end, I think, but mm-hmm. it's pretty heavy at the beginning. I like it a lot.
Yeah.
I like it a lot.
And I think it's a good, like, beginner stout beer, too.
Yeah,
like,
I'd say so.
If you're looking to get into darker fare.
You get that full stout flavor right at the beginning, and then it kind of gets sweeter towards the end. What do you think about the Old Chub?
Oh, my goodness. The world. I think the world of it.
Oh, man.
Thank you, Oskar Blues, for making this delicious brew.
You've been to Oskar Blues or no?
I've been to
You have been to Oskar
One of them. They have, like, four different locations.
Really?
And I think, like, three of them have, like, a brew pub thing. Actually, the one I went to was just a tasting room, so it didn't have food.
Okay.
But they have, like, a full restaurant and I think a brew pub area. They've got a good operation out there in Colorado, in the Longmont area, which is, like, northwest of Denver.
Right.
It's maybe a little further out than a suburb, but like for anybody familiar with the Indianapolis area, like how Noblesville is to Indy,
mm-hmm.
you know, it's very accessible from the city.
Is that where you stayed out there? Are you in Longmont?
No. We're staying up in the mountains with my sister in the around the Vale area. It's probably an hour and a half from where we were staying into Denver.
I got you.
And a very scenic drive. Man, those mountains are cool mm-hmm. any time of year. But I'll read it again. We did read it earlier, actually, that it features a dense head, creamy mouthfuls of flavor of caramel, chocolate, lightly roasted malt. And it really is. I mean, it's on nitro, it really is a beer milkshake because it does have that very nice sweet. It's not overly sweet, but for a beer, it's quite mm-hmm. sweet. Oh, man. It just
and he is enjoying it.
It just hits so right. I do love my Scotch ales, though, so I might be a little biased. If you're a big hop head, it might not be the beer for you. There's
no
trace of hops, really.
No, not at all.
I mean, I'm
all.
Sure there are some to counteract a little.
Can't taste them. I don't think so. When I tried it, I mean, it was...
Yeah.
Huh.
I love it. And that actually, we sort of already did it, but our brewery spotlight is on Oskar Blues.
There you go.
And they... Their first beer was brewed in 1998. They actually opened a grill and brew restaurant in 97.
Huh.
And then they started brewing in the basement of that. And they first brewed a stout, which I think is unusual because I don't know many breweries where you hear that a stout is their first
beer
attempt. Yeah, they usually go with something a little hoppier,
mm-hmm.
like an IPA fare, a little lighter in color and hoppier.
Right.
But I might be wrong on that. But it won a bronze medal at the Great American Brew Festival, which takes place in Denver.
Oh, okay.
So, I mean, it was kind of in their backyard, but it is a serious festival. Like, if you get any medals from the GABF...
You're doing something right.
Totally. Like, that's the gold medal standard for... Literally the gold medal standard for any craft brewer.
Hmm.
So to get a bronze in their first year is amazing. And then in 2002, they started... expanding. They were the first craft brewer to can its own beer.
Oh,
like there had been canned craft breweries, but they didn't have to source it out, which is cool. And it was the Dale's Pale Ale, which is great. And
yeah, it is. Definitely had that.
The Deviant Dale's is also very good. It's like the double.
Mm-hmm. Are all their beers canned?
Mm-hmm.
None bottled.
I'm pretty sure they don't bottle.
I've never seen any bottled. Every time I've had a beer from them, it's been in a can.
Anything we get in Indiana, it's definitely canned.
Yeah.
And some breweries, and I'm seeing it more, really stick to canning.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I believe Tin Man is really big into canning. Sun King only cans. So
that is true.
I don't know. I'd love to hear the argument, like if it helps preserve it or
yeah, I don't know anything about that. That'd be a good topic of discussion, I guess. Yeah.
So that's awesome. And this is the one thing Oskar Blues has that I've not heard of any other brewery really having. Maybe Sierra Nevada can kind of compete, but it's a little different. They have their own farm.
Hmm.
And it's not just a farm for grain. They call it their hops and heifers. They do grow, I don't know if it's all the meat for their restaurant part of their operation.
Right.
But I think a lot of it's grown there. And that might have started.
That's cool.
There. Yeah. So
hops and heifers.
Here's to you, Oskar Blues. Well, well frickin' done.
Well played.
Well, Brooks, you know what time it is?
I think I do.
It's time for This Day in Beer History.
Woo.
Takes us back to January 2nd, 1903.
Okay, fairly recent.
Fairly recent.
Compared to some of the things.
Last century.
Yeah.
Milwaukee Morning News.
What?
Yeah.
Sounds credible.
The headline reads, Miller finds alternative to champagne for next year's New Year's celebration. Tired of just toasting champagne on January 1st? So are the brewers over at Miller. Head brewer Jim This Guy says, champagne tastes terrible, and the spelling is worse. We don't need to import something from France to celebrate New Year's in the States. So we wanted to come up with a beer substitute. Miller has brewed a crisp American-style lager with extra carbonation to try and bring the best of champagne with a good taste of beer into one drink that you can toast to a new year.
Mm.
They're calling it High Life. The only thing still in question is how Miller will market their new product. Jim, this guy's early concept is, maybe we can get a delivery guy to make fun of situations that champagne drinkers would participate in and say that our new High Life wouldn't be there because it's for the everyman.
Ah.
The article, of course, goes on. But I feel like that was very appropriate since it's gone on to be the champagne of beers.
It has indeed, the champagne of beers.
Yeah.
It's a great story. Great,
it is.
This day in beer history. Very informative.
A little easier to pull up on the Google, too. Not written in a foreign language.
Yeah, that's nothing lost in translation, as you will.
Exactly. Exactly. Well, Brooks, another episode's going in the books. I've had a great time.
It's been a good one, once again.
This old Chub's so good. And I love the name.
Yeah, it's a pretty solid name.
The dirty old man of names for beer.
Old Chub. Old Chub.
Well, and I want to thank you for listening. Again, if you guys can subscribe, that would be great.
Mm-hmm.
You'll get all of the new shows right as they happen. Try to post them about every Monday, unless I get terrifically sick like I did this week.
Yeah. Do we have a guest next week or anything planned to let the people know?
I'm trying to get a guest. I've not been successful in getting a guest, so it may just be Brooks and I again. But hey, that's the core.
Yeah.
That's what you guys are coming for, right?
You're here for us, and sometimes you listen to some other people, too. It's all right.
Thanks again for listening. Drink on.
Sitting on my bed in my red pajamas, watching Michigan State take on Indiana, and honey, thought you'd like to know. I don't mean to be apologizing, and I hate wasting time philosophizing, 'cause baby, I'm a little bit slow. I know a lot of people catch on to things quicker, and maybe I spend too much time with my liquor, and I stand still while the others go. And I never get jokes until hours later, and then I crack up in a crowded elevator, 'cause baby,